Hello. Today we are going to take you on a tour of your lab, the Ecology Lab. Located on the ground floor of the Environment One building, the Faculty of Environment Ecology Lab is the go-to teaching facility for environment students. We support all things ecology and we're your one-stop shop for both lab and field support.
Open during the week from 8:30 to 4:30, staff are typically available to welcome you into this facility. You may even recognize your colleagues working in the lab, as several full-time co-op assistants help facilitate lab activities. Part-time students as well as volunteers are also essential in helping the Ecology Lab run each term.
The Ecology Lab has a vast array of both field and lab equipment to support you in your learning. Do you have questions about soil fertility or water quality? Would you like to do a vegetation inventory or conduct weather measurements? Ask us about our variety of field equipment for sampling soils, water, vegetation, or weather, including measuring tapes, quadrats, plant presses, various weather instruments, and multimeters for measuring pH, dissolved oxygen, temperature, or electrical conductivity. For your analysis, come into the lab to use equipment such as drying ovens, analytical mass balance, or spectrophotometers for measuring parameters such as nitrate or phosphate levels.
The water sampling equipment you can borrow includes chest waders, life jackets, sampling bottles, YSI multimeters, swaffers to measure water velocity, and D-nets and buckets to sample for benthic invertebrates. If you want to sample soil, we have what you need, including shovels and augers. And don't forget about safety equipment, including mosquito nets and in-lab equipment such as lab coats, goggles, gloves, and flasks. In addition, we have microscopes and scales, to name a few of the many items that you can use for your research projects.
Perhaps you are wondering about where to start with plant ID, or you found an interesting insect and you'd like to know what it is. The Ecology Lab has a vast library of books covering a wide range of topics, including plant ID, birds, mushrooms, sampling techniques, and so much more. These books can also be borrowed. And on our website, you can find a list of our book inventory as well as other relevant information.
Equipment can be signed out and borrowed from the Ecology Lab, and a full list of equipment can be found on our website, which is linked in our link tree in the description below this video. So now you've borrowed some equipment but forgot how to use it? Check out our YouTube channel with tutorials on how to use different equipment and also tutorials on different sampling techniques. We also have videos on plant ID, insect ID, as well as numerous other videos for you to check out. We can also help with research questions you may have, including experimental design, different sampling methods, and species identification. Email us or feel free to drop in to chat when we're open.
You can further improve your identification skills by accessing the Ecology Lab's collections of different specimens, both physical in the lab and online, which can be accessed from our website. In the lab, we have collections of preserved benthic invertebrates. These collections can help with learning identification characteristics of different taxa, provide historical information, and help with species ID. Birds. Tree samples and cores. An herbarium with thousands of specimens. Lichens, mosses, and fungi. And tons of different skulls. Our collections are also archived online and are available for you to view anywhere.
The Ecology Lab facilitates various courses, which collects data on Laurel Creek, which runs the full length of campus. This data includes biological, physical, and chemical measurements. In addition to this coursework, the Ecology Lab collects various data around campus. In the UW Urban Forest, weather measurements, tree health, and invasive plant inventories are recorded. You may be wondering what happens to all the research data collected by students through coursework and student research projects.
There is a wide range of data available on Dataverse. This is an open source data sharing platform hosted by Scholars Portal, a life of our UW library page. We have data on Laurel Creek dating back to 2009. Feel free to reach out to us if you are looking for data on a particular topic.
You can self-register for the Digital Ecology Lab on Learn to gain access to thousands of documents and historical data on topics such as birds, wetlands, invasive species, Laurel Creek, regional documents on environmentally significant policy areas, and much more.
The Ecology Lab hosts various workshops and webinars, including soap making, DIY terrariums, insect ID, vermicomposting, and plant ID, to name a few. These are a great way to learn a new skill while meeting new people. And we're always open to running new workshops. So if there's a topic you're passionate or knowledgeable about, we'd love to collaborate on setting something up.
Be sure to check out the bulletin board, which is right outside our main lab and near the tree lab, which is open at the same hours as the ecology lab is, which is 8:30 to 4:30. This lab can be used as a study space when not being used for scheduled lab activities. Actually, all of the labs are available for you to work in if there isn't a class scheduled.
Right beside the tree lab is the ESS student-run coffee shop and lounge where you can buy fair trade coffee in a reusable mug, grab a board game, and have a place to study or hang out with friends. Another cool study space is the environment courtyard just upstairs. Outside of the courtyard, you can find the living wall and display cases, which the Ecology Lab rotates exhibits according to different themes and seasons.
The Ecology Lab also manages various naturalized gardens around the environment buildings. This supports biodiversity by providing native plants as food sources and habitat for native wildlife. The Ecology Lab maintains these spaces by removing invasive species and having students plant more native species annually. This is the Dorney Garden, which, established in 1988, was one of the first naturalized gardens on a Canadian university campus.
Going around to the other side of EV1, you will find many other gardens the Ecology Lab maintains, including the Prairie Savanna and Arts Environment Gardens, to name a few. These gardens provide support for pollinators, are home to some at-risk species, such as the prickly pear cactus, and give students and teachers a place on campus to eat, relax, learn, and enjoy nature.
Check out our website for more information on these gardens, and feel free to stop by the lab to borrow equipment, check out our collections or gardens, or just to chat. We would love for you to drop by.